Well, we're out here today because 2 years ago we measured volatilization of PAHs off of freshly applied coal tar seal coat, and we found some extraordinarily high rates and numbers. And so we want to verify those, and we're also at the same time sampling much more intensively and with several other instruments that we didn't have last time to try to do the best job we possibly can to quantify this volatilization flux and see how important an air contaminant is.
At the same time, we're going to be doing some runoff experiments so we can look at the effects, the potentially toxic effects of stormwater runoff from recently seal-coated parking lots on aquatic biota. Did Pete tell you some of the numbers we've gotten off these?
No, he was talking about it.
It's just
some pretty nasty stuff, though.
Astronomical.
Yeah, I think today we're tying the all-time record for 100-degree highs in Austin, and tomorrow we'll clearly break it.
Yeah, it's like those air timers. So, this is a simple field test to determine if it is the asphalt-based seal coat or the coal tar-based seal coat. The coal tar is not soluble in mineral spirits, which is what is in this jar. And so you can see it's remained perfectly clear, and there's little blobs of seal coat down on the bottom, and there's no dissolution or dissolving or mixing. The asphalt-based product is soluble in mineral spirits. So if it was the asphalt-based product, this would look like a cup of coffee. And you wouldn't be able to see through it. You wouldn't be able to see the individual blobs of seal coat. So it's just a quick way to ensure that the product that they said they put down is really what they put down.
One more piece of foil after this too, because I want to do five of them. They come up easier than I thought.
Here's the bottom. This little tin disc. So this is good, because we've never been able to know for sure just how much of the stuff is on the pavement. And not knowing that, we can't make any mass calculations. So we have to make an estimate just based on the applicator rates, but we have no idea if they follow those guidelines or if they would even know how much they're putting out. So now we can tell.
Today marks 69 days in a row in Austin that we've been over 100 degrees, and here we are at 2 in the afternoon on a black parking lot. We're out here because about 8 years ago we were part of a group with us, USGS, and the city of Austin that discovered that pavement seal coat, the black stuff that you see on the pavement behind us here, is a major source of a certain kind of contamination in urban environments, PAHs, or polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. And being hydrologists in that, when we first discovered this, we discovered it in runoff. So we did a study that's kind of like what we're doing now, part of it, where we had parking lots coated commercially with this product, and then we simulated runoff and we measured contaminant levels, PAH levels, in the runoff. And in that first study, we found that they were very high, about 65 times higher in runoff from coal tar sealed parking lots, which is the main product type, the same product that's behind us here, and runoff from unsealed parking lots. Well, we fast forward to 2 years ago, 2009, and we did a study out here where we moved past the question of water quality to air, because we know when this stuff is applied, you can smell it, very strong odor, and that means it's volatilizing.
There's a little bit more to it than that. In fact, as we were doing our runoff studies, we would take scraping samples of the product itself, of the dried material, and what we noticed was that when you scraped up the dried material and you measured the concentration, it still had extremely high concentrations of PAHs, but they weren't as high as what was in the product itself. So somewhere between when you put the product on the surface and when it dries and you scrape it back off, you're losing some of those PAHs. And so the question is, are they going into the air? And that made sense because we can smell very strongly right now that there are PAHs being volatilized from the surface behind us, but we wanted to measure how important this type of seal coat might be to PAHs in the atmosphere.
Very true. So the same patch of ground behind us, 50 by 50 foot square area, was seal coated 2 years ago, and we sampled air concentrations right on the surface with a thing called a hat sampler that's a round steel disc that has a high volume air sampler at the center, and it samples the surface air layer. We sampled concentrations about 4 feet off the surface with a second high volume sampler. And with those two and with wind speed, you can make an estimate of the total flux of PAHs to the air, the total amount of volatilization. And what we found from that initial study in our first sample, 2 hours after the seal coat was applied, was an extremely high concentration of PAHs in air and a really high volatilization rate. Well, we're back today because in that study we sampled relatively infrequently right after sampling and spread over a whole year, and we realized when we look at the results from it that a whole lot of the action, a whole lot of the volatilization was happening in the first few minutes or hours after application. And so we wanted to repeat the study, and we're also doing, with the same sampling method we used, we've also got another USGS researcher, Mike Majewski from California, who has a set of tower samplers that are you see the ones here with the little wind anemometers turning, and then there's another pole over to the right of those with some hoses leading to it. Those are a more traditional method for sampling air concentrations of contaminants and measuring flux. So we're trying to compare two different methods here and verify the results we got the first time we were out.
We're also going to collect samples more frequently than we did the first time around. The first time we collected sample 1 day and then 4 days and then 2 weeks after sampling. Here we're going to collect samples. We collected samples as soon as the seal coat was laid down, 2 hours afterwards,
1 hour
afterwards. Yeah. And then now, which is about 4 hours afterwards, we're going to collect another one tomorrow morning at 6 a.m., another one tomorrow afternoon. So we'll be able to have a much better description of what those PAH concentrations are in the first few days after application.
And then the other thing we're doing that we have not done before, and as far as we know, no one has done in the way we are, is that there is a lot of evidence out there that the runoff, if it does rain soon after the seal coat is applied, is very toxic. There have been 2 fish kills that we know of when it has rained within a day or so of application of seal coat in the streams that those parking lots drained into. And there's one study that measured toxicity in runoff from seal coat from a seal coated parking lot when it rained about a day after they seal coated. And found real high toxicity. So we're doing a much more controlled experiment than that, where we're going to simulate runoff 4 hours after application, 12 hours, 24, 48, 72 hours, to try to see how toxic the runoff is and for how long. How long of a curing time is it before you get back to some fairly normal level of parking lot runoff as far as that goes.
And then we're going to do all of these same types of sampling, but we're going to do them in a few weeks on a surface that has been treated with a different type of seal coat, one that has an asphalt base as opposed to the coal tar base. And the big difference is that the coal tar product contains 50 to 100,000 milligrams per kilogram of PAHs, and the asphalt-based product contains about 50. So there's about 1,000 times more PAHs in the coal tar-based product than in the asphalt-based product. So we can compare volatilization and toxicity between these two product types.
Yeah, and that's a really important point, because the coal tar product has now been banned in Austin, where we are. We had to get special permission to do this. And in more than a dozen other U.S. cities and in the state of Washington, and the alternative is this asphalt-based product. So we also want to test it to see how environmentally friendly or safe it is.
Yeah, important to see how substantial the difference really is from an environmental point of view between the two products.
So tell us about the night sample.
About the night sample?
Why you're out here in the middle of the night.
No, we're out here in the middle of the night because we want to sample at certain time periods after the seal coat is applied. And this is the 12 hours after, so it happens to be 11 p.m. And that's because we are wondering how toxicity varies in runoff with time afterwards. And we want to sample it. Specific and pretty close time periods after the runoff, after the application of the seal coat. So this is 12 hours after. The three major findings, I would say, of the studies of seal coat, the first one is simply that it has extremely high concentrations of PAHs. And that's in the product, it's in dust that's swept off of the parking lot, it's in runoff, it's in air concentrations next to the parking lots. So it's just a really strong source of this group of contaminants.
A second major finding is that it doesn't stay where you put it. Coal tar seal coat wears off. You can see it on the parking lot around us, that you can see the asphalt through the seal coat. And that's normal, and that's why applicators recommend that you have it reapplied every 3, 4, 5 years. The question is, where does it go? And we found that it comes off in stormwater runoff, it gets tracked into people's homes, it ends up in stormwater detention ponds, it ends up in our lakes and rivers, and it ends up in the air. So there are a number of different environmental compartments that are affected.
Yeah, and to elaborate on one of the things Barbara just mentioned as a major finding is our studies of lake sediment chemistry around the United States have shown that concentrations of the PAHs have been increasing in urban lakes across the U.S. for the last 30 or 40 years, and that the dominant source of PAHs to those lakes is the coal tar-based pavement seal coat.